So folks, you join us here at Lineside Studios for the challenge we've all been waiting on. It's the Speedy versus the screwdriver. This time it's a little change around because Gary has dropped his popular Speedy one that he has found a use for, and he's opted for the traditional screwdriver. So in the red corner we have Gary Hayes. In the other red corner we have Joe Robinson, who has this new Speedy 2. So let's cut straight to the action.
So now you've got your screwdriver ready, Gary.
Yes.
I'm going to grab my screwdriver, get that out,
well,
ready to go.
I've got a secret weapon as well.
Yeah.
I've got a pair of glasses, so I've got the power of vision. Okay, I'm ready to start when you are. Go.
Can I? Well, I've not even got my screwdriver out. So I've got to get mine all set up before I even start
well,
doing
that's
up the
screws. That's the problem with your one, isn't it?
You've not got to go and forge your screwdriver.
I'm already two ahead.
Okay. Right, get started on here. Okay, and there's no power, so I need to put the battery in.
Yep.
You've really stitched me up here again, haven't you?
Well, it's the screwdriver you wanted to choose. Mine just comes out of a toolbox and use it straight away, so it doesn't go flat ever.
All right, I'll get mine set to max power for these terminals.
Not sure that was meant to go in that one. We're not doing these in number order, are we, at the end? You're going to tell me I've not ordered mine correctly.
Well, you just volley them in, mate, and then we'll decide what we're going to do afterwards, yeah?
Make sure you get the right torque set in there, young man.
Oh, absolutely.
Torque's built into my elbow already.
I've got this set to the max setting for the terminals on
What's
the
outside. What's that, half a newton metre?
That's one newton. Nearly lost it out my hand there. That was close.
Okay, well.
I'm glad Gordon was on the close-up for that embarrassing part. That's good. There we go. How many have you done now, G?
I've done one set, so I've done 10.
One whole set? You're on fire, my man. I reckon this is going to be close, you know?
It isn't. I'm tiring already.
Tiring? You're only doing screws up. More of a marathon than a sprint, this one, isn't it?
Yeah, okay. I used to like a marathon.
What's that in?
Not physically running one, just obviously eating one before they...
What's a marathon then?
Yes.
Is that like a chocolate bar or something?
Yeah, I changed it to Snickers. Yes.
Changed it to Snickers?
Nice. Yeah, no doubt you've used to an opal fruit as well.
What?
Yeah, what else can we do on that? Pesos. Remember those?
No, I was joking about the other ones, but I genuinely have no idea what you're talking about now. Right, here we go.
Well, we've got so many to do. I would have won if we'd have only had 10.
Oh, so you've switched from bottom to top there, I noticed. That's interesting.
It doesn't matter. We've all got to go in eventually, haven't we?
Yeah, I suppose so.
Have you nearly done a set?
Very nearly. Now, what's quite interesting about this
It better be interesting when you said it. It's
got
to be interesting now. You know you said that.
Well,
the audience are waiting for interesting. Let's go for Robinson's interesting.
We know that people love to comment, don't they? They love to have a look at what's going on in the video, and they love to comment on it. Now, I'm sure that we're going to get some comments on the slight gap that exists between the trunking on here.
It does look like
yourself.
It's been through joinery workshop,
suggest. We sent that over to WIHA, our sister channel, to get that put together there. And very kindly, they left us some ventilation gaps there so that the cables don't overheat inside the trunking. Very clever. Very clever, I thought. Okay. How are you doing, guys? You onto your buzz bar yet?
Yeah, just finishing off. Just the first, that's it done. Not bothering with the second side, are we?
Yeah. And have you noticed what delicious treat awaits us sitting on the bench there?
I always struggle with the word log and food.
Caramel log, yeah.
I'll probably have a shoe bun after I've won. I can wander off to the fridge to pick it up.
It always makes me think it must be a mathematical snack, you know. It's like log to the base, coconut equals caramel, something along those lines.
And for those viewers with their education, yeah.
Very good.
I'm on my last set. What are you on?
I'll tell you what, this takes me back. I'm loving this.
What,
this
using
nice.
The Speedy?
Well,
the
you know,
tea stirrer of the electrical industry,
I
unless
truly,
the tea's
truly wish.
Half and half milk and coffee, milk, water, coffee.
Well, it wouldn't be tea then. It wouldn't be tea then, would it, Gary? If it was half coffee, what would that be?
Well, that's what Gordon has. When you ask him for a drink, he says, you go, well, do you want a cup of tea? Yeah, I'll have a tea. Coffee. Oh, right, is that a new beverage, is it?
Very good. Now, we should mention to the crowd that you attempted to have a little cheat earlier on in this this race, didn't you, before we started off camera there?
No, it's not cheating.
Because we've got these little buzz bars to go in the top here, which I'm sure that you're probably already doing up as we speak, I would imagine. And you'd already done a couple of those screws up, hadn't you? So we decided to start those off not in at all. Okay. All right, now I'm going to change to the min setting now, because I'm doing these slightly more.
Will it be able to rotate itself around with the power in it?
There we go. I'm not convinced that's gripping. Oh dear. I've stumbled, Gaz. You've got an option now.
I only had two screwdrivers in my hand. I could do two at once.
That's interesting. Why is that not going in? Ah, I've got it upside down. Oh, there we go. Do you know what, Gaz? I reckon I've done you a favour there, my old mate. I reckon that's on you now. I reckon you could do this. I might have to start trying. There we go. How's your heartbeat doing there, mate? How's your pulse rate doing?
Just
up a little bit.
Final bar to do and I'm done.
Blood pressure flying up a little bit.
Oh, you're flat, are you? You're flat.
Oh dear. No, I think I was just not quite twisting it properly. You know, I am going to be checking that every single one of those is done up properly. Oh yeah. Come have a look. Yeah. There we go.
Three to go. How are we doing there?
No.
They're not as tight as I thought they were.
I'm not sure. I think I might have missed. Oh no, I've got it. There we go. Yep, they're all in. Don't worry.
One to go.
We all know who doesn't
cheat.
You've
got two to go.
I tell you what, this is going to be tight.
They ought to make push fit versions of these. I would have won.
Assuming you're not lying, of course. There we go. And that's the last one done. I'm going to enjoy my caramel log.
I'm there. I've just got this one, I think.
Taste on that. Just that one. I'll give you a hand here, mate. I'll point out the ones you've not quite managed to do.
I've got to do it twice now. I've put them in once and then I'm going to do it again. So again, screwdriver wins. Mine hasn't gone flat during the task.
I do have caramel log all over my board now.
for those people who now will put the translation up, I would think on the screen, so you'll be able to understand what Joe's saying when he's got a mouthful of caramel log.
Just wondering what the environmental code is for caramel log in your electrical installation. Not sure what that is. AE, is it? I'm not sure.
Further investigation, I think. Hmm. Nearly there. One more to go.
This is some good log.
Yeah, sorry. For all those people who don't speak caramel log, that was something. Yeah. Hmm. Was that
cut on your finger before we started?
It isn't even powerful enough to move the tea around. Look at that. Look, absolutely. Look, it's just hopeless. Absolutely hopeless. You're going to have to operate that one by hand. I think we'll call that a win to me.
I think we're going to have to go over to the adjudicators, aren't we?
So, Gary, another crushing defeat.
It's an absolute joke. That screwdriver's still a joke. We've got no idea how tight they are. He's gone round with that, egg whisk of a screwdriver in order to put the bar in and the connections. I want a second inquiry on those terminations. They're a joke.
Well, we'll see what Joe has to say about that, Gary. But how are you feeling generally after that race?
My wrist is absolutely burning. After about 11 of those, knowing that we had to do 60 connections, I was properly struggling there. But I powered through the pain to take, I think, the win. I think you agree that I won that one?
Not exactly. Let's see what Joe has to say about this. So, Joe, congratulations on the win.
I actually just enjoy taking part. It's just a good fun day out, isn't it?
Oh, well, but Gary cast some dispersions about the torque settings of the terminals there. Is that something you'd like to comment on?
It's great, actually, because the Speedy 2, if you put it to max, does up to a torque of 1 newton metre, which is perfect for the larger terminals. And on min, it does it to 0.4 newton metres, which is perfect for the busbars there.
Okay, and your wrist, generally, feeling?
I'll be honest, I didn't even know I had wrists. Yeah, absolutely fine.
Well, there you go, folks. The conclusive evidence, the Speedy makes life easy for anybody who's taking on masses of the same terminal and wants to get them to the right torque.